Please, speak.
Spotted something. What's this? I found something. Focus! Being sustained by Source.
Intruder!
Nice.
Thank you. The ghost looks around the room with an incredulous shake of his head and fixates on the set of paintings before him.
What a fool I've been. Thieving was the best chance I had of keeping afloat in this wretched city. Never thought that would mean trying to impress a band of urchins, let alone getting crushed by a damn golem. Big Tomorrow said they'd let me in their grubby little guild if I helped them nab that painting of Kems, the second Passion of Lucian. Well, we made it in all right, and while Kems' constructs tore me to shreds, they all ran off with a painting. If you don't know her, it's best to keep it that way. That thieves give
you! You!
Thank you.
Intruder! Intruder!
Thank you.
Intruder! Intruder!
I'll see you. Not.
Yes.
Good fight. Focus!
Damn!
Focus!
The helmet of the Devourer resembles a dragon's head. Longing pins you in place as ash begins to fall from above. The world is a crudely woven tapestry, but you are an artisan beyond compare. You want, no, need, the finest craftsmanship. Heat envelops you from head to toe as a guttural voice rises. It snuffs out the longing with its first breath.
I see you, and inside you is the strength I've been looking for. Find the workshop where the craft mistress flourished. I will draw strength from there to speak again.
The longing turns sharp, obsessive. You must return to your workshop. As the pangs fade, someone else lingers near you. An imperious, elegant woman stares down her nose at you.
What are you looking at? Where have you taken me? This is not Arx. I must hear the voice of my finest creation again. I polished every piece with care for the Empress. Close, I hear its song. The Outlaw Empress believed in me, believed in my vision. Perfection must be mine again. Take me to the workshop. My masterpiece awaits.
Find.
You see yourself in the mirror. It's quite a sight.
Yes? Last I heard, Dallas has something that belongs to us. Let's get her.
Which part? Who could look at all those people and destroy them without a second thought? Apart from Malady, of course. I know I crossed a line. But it wasn't a line between good and bad. It was a line between knowing and not knowing. I would have preferred not to know. How dark the night can get. How close you can stand at the edge of oblivion and feel nothing. But I did what I had to do. And I'd do it again. As for the rest of the realm's demons. Well, what is it they say? The first cut slices the deepest. Once this one scabs over, I'll be ready to hunt out the rest of them, wherever they're hiding. Maybe it's just that. A crusade. Maybe when it comes right down to it, I'll get in front of a crowd again and forget everything I saw here. I never saw myself as a hero. But then again, maybe I never really saw myself before. May as well get to it then. Hey, everything okay? Anytime, Chief. Anytime at all.
Come to me, the night is long. Sing for me, I'll sing along. Sing for me, oh sing for me. Sway with me, we'll make them scream. Dance with me, we'll make them bleed. Sing for me, I'll sing along. Sing for me, oh sing for me.
Yes?
She flings her hands into the air, closes her eyes and laughs.
I feel real.
She twirls in place, then stands straight, arms at her sides, still smiling.
I feel like I can take on the world. As for Dallas, bring it on. Yes?
So, here we are again.
Windigo lies on the floor, her essence all but drained from her frail bones. She shifts with a light clatter at the sight of you.
The God King's punishment awaits. I pray it arrives soon. I came for the Swornbreaker. I found only Kem's fury. This is what becomes of the King's fallen angels, Godwoken. Mockery, torture, decay. A shrine to the God King. Linda Kem's holy refuge. And, it seems, my tomb. A Swornbreaker? Please, I beg of you, end this curse.
Let the God King have her. Once Black Ring, always Black Ring.
She can beg all she wants. The Swornbreaker is ours, and that's that.
Has she once shown that she deserves our pity? It's all just a trick.
Consider me moved, Godwoken. Your mercy is boundless. And now I break his shackles and end this misery. No goodbye has ever been sweeter.
Windigo's bones clatter to the floor. She is free to enter the hall, free of the God King's shackles. You hear a voice echoing within you, Windigo's voice.
I am me, and only me. The next move is yours, Godwoken.
It wasn't her that failed her lord, it was her lord that failed her.
Windigo's spirit quakes. She is no longer the arrogant banshee that summoned a kraken and brought down a magister vessel, but a fearful child bracing for parental punishment.
He's close, so close. Can't you feel him, Godwoken? The King approaches.
A moment of silence passes, and then Windigo's scream splits the air.
He's tearing away my soul, Godwoken. Cast me to the void if you must, but do not let him take me.
Windigo's spirit flutters and writhes. Your skull squeezes tight, and your throat burns with fire, but the substance of her being is nearly yours. Your head shrieks as if split in two by the God King's umbrage, but you have overcome. Windigo's source funnels into you in steady gushes as you sling her spirit into the void.
Thank you.
A dagger of pain shoots through your head, halting your advance instantly. You hear a voice, soft and calm, yet laced with disappointment.
Such a long journey you have undertaken, in the service of thieving charlatans, in pursuit of that which you will never obtain.
A long, sad sigh reaches you from the depths of the void itself.
I saw your abysmal treatment of my servant Isbael. Please test my patience no further. This is your last chance. Abandon this folly. Leave and never return.
I am the past. I will be the future. I am the God King. You are but a misguided servant. Heed my words and leave. I do not wish you harm unless you force my hand. Because my followers are many, my followers are everywhere. Your endeavors are pointless.
The voice fades away, and with it, the pain.
Look,
only
the
God King knows the weight of responsibility. Only the God King knows the weight of responsibility.
Thank you.
Only the God King knows the weight of responsibility.
Lucky find. Ghosts, and they're tearing the soul apart. There's someone here. He seems to be in great pain.
Yes.
I won't budge. Too heavy. Won't budge. Too heavy. Too heavy. Rubbish.
Flesh is well past ripe. Whatever memories it once held are now gone.
The man before you writhes in pain, oblivious to you. Otherworldly shackles are coiled all around him. The man raises his head with an anguished groan.
There is nothing you can do. Save yourself. I am Ahu. Well, your search is at an end. Apologies if you were expecting a more convivial setting.
He coughs up a gout of blood. Before he can dissuade you any further, his eyes roll back and he loses consciousness. The man doesn't respond to you. He said...
Good find.
The spirit ignores you, focused as it is on tearing the source from its captive. It stinks of dark magic. There's nothing in the spirit but pain, its own and that of its captive. He resists the agony, but it's only a matter of time before the spirits tear his source away. The pain begins to hurt you too. The dark stench assails you. The spirit concentrates on tearing the source from its captive. The dark stench assails you. The spirit concentrates on tearing the... The spirit seizes the pain you inflict upon it and turns it back on you. The pain you share nears unbearable levels, and the spirit begins to smile. This is the pinnacle of its existence. And then it exists no more. The pain it gave you ebbs away.
Stop! I told you to leave! You're going to kill me! Just go, damn you!
He shudders as fresh waves of pain course through him.
Leave, or you still have a chance! And don't touch the...
He passes out, mid-sentence. The dark stench as the spirit seizes the pain, and then it exists.
Stop! Yeah! Stop! Please stop! The pain, it's too much.
His face goes slack as the pain renders him senseless. The man is oblivious to you. The dark stench, the spirit sees, and then it...
My dear Lord Ahu, you should have told me you were expecting visitors.
Run, you fools!
That, I'm afraid, is a matter of perspective. From where I stand, all of you must die. Everything depends on it.
Why, Kim? Why betray everything for which you once stood?
Betray? I didn't betray the Order. I liberated it. As one of Lucian's pawns, I stood for weakness. Frailty. And then... Then the God King showed me the world as it could be. He made me a promise. He promised me a path unburdened by Lucian's pathetic need to defend the defenseless. He promised me a world dominated by the worthiest bloodlines across the ages. He promised me a lasting seat at his glorious table in return for my oath. For the King chooses only the strongest. The most loyal, the most deserving. And now, Godwoken, I uphold the final act of my oath. Your
execution. You can forget about finding Lucien. Believe me, no good comes from our so-called divine.
I cannot. I am near drained of my source.
You were always weak, wizard. You just never knew it. It's time for me to teach you the truth.